All right, stargazers, get ready. The next major meteor shower of 2020 is coming up in April.
And this morning, Rochelle Peart looks into the science behind those cosmic displays.
When you wish upon a star.
Jiminy Cricket said, "When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true." I'm not sure if Jiminy knew that what you're wishing on is flaming hot, but all in all, it's just a rock.
I got a quarter.
I got a rock.
Shooting stars are actually meteoroids that fall through the Earth's atmosphere as meteors. It's all because as the Earth orbits, we move through space debris left over from different comets.
You can think of kind of like a dirty snowball. So as the comet gets closer to the sun in its orbit, it melts, leaves behind a bunch of little pebbles and rocks.
Justin Mason is the planetarium director at Old Dominion University.
Meteors burn up in our atmosphere and leaves a streak of light across the sky.
But the real show comes during a meteor shower.
They can be anywhere from 15 meters an hour to 50 to even 100 or 120. Depends on which one you go out and see. Some of the best ones in the year are the Perseids, early to mid-August. That peaks around 100 to 120 meters an hour.
Because of how our orbit is set up, we know when certain meteor showers take place, like the Perseids. But how are meteor showers named? It depends on which way the Earth is facing, but all you have to do is look up.
If you follow all the meteor streaks as they pass through the sky, they all angle back towards a certain specific constellation.
Rochelle Peart, 13 News Now.
And Rochelle will be back next week. If you have something you want her to look into, send her an email or reach out on social media.